Hi, good afternoon, sir. Could you please elaborate on the hurdles that you face from different quarters?
Oh, I don't see hurdles. I never see them as hurdles. Basically, if there is some problem at hand, we try to solve the problem. I don't look them as hurdles anyway. There are issues, of course, and we could resolve them.
Good afternoon, sir. I'm Sindhu. What future do you see for OU, like, in general?
Yeah, as I already told you, there is a bright future for this university, right? So, this university can become, as I said, one of the centers of innovations. For that, actually, of course, you require a good academic atmosphere, and there should be a quality research that taking place. And then there should be ecosystem, for encouraging the faculty members and students in engaging the innovation activities. So we have to create that kind of environment. We are on the way actually now. I think you must have seen that recently. Today we have inaugurated that Technology Business Incubator. So this is one of those activities which we have initiated just to, encourage this faculty and students to do innovation.
Sir, could you comment on the particular areas which needs to be further strengthened to improve our global ranking?
Yeah, we have to strengthen our research. As I told you, every year I see around 450 scholars graduating, right, getting their PhD degrees. It's a good number, I would say. But how many of them actually are becoming innovations? So that is very important. So we have to focus on quality research. So that kind of environment should exist. It requires effort from the teachers. Teachers have to engage the scholars. As I told you, we get very bright students. Right, but then you have to guide them properly, you have to mentor them properly, right? You just show them the way forward, and they are on their own way. Actually, quite often that is what exactly happens, right? Many times I tell them to do this one way, and they come with number of alternate solutions also. So it's a learning process for both the teacher as well as the student. So, in fact, I learned more from my students rather than myself. So, because, the students are very young, energetic, and they have a lot of time at their disposal. So they can spend, more time and then come with alternate solutions also. Give a problem which is very relevant, right? And also it is very important that we interface with the industry. Okay, all the research that we do should be relevant. In order that to be relevant, then we should have, collaboration with the industry also. Because that is where actually our research is going to be used. Right? Ultimately, the research has to be useful, right? So if it is useful, where do you find this use? Right? In the industry. So you have to have collaborations with industry, and then find what are the problems that we can give to the students, and also you should be visiting industries also. I think there should be some kind of sabbatical where our teachers go and spend some time in the industry also, and also invite the industry people to deliver the lectures here. So that kind of environment should exist where there is a win-win situation.
So, how do you look at your transition from an academic to an administrator?
Yeah, it is a smooth process, I would say. Because, you know, prior to this assignment, I was also the principal of University College of Engineering. I have also observed the administrators very closely during my long, you know, 30 years long service. Okay, I have some ideas, you know, how to do things. It's not that I just came from academics into administration. There is a, you know, process actually. I was the head of the department, then I was the principal also. And in many committees at the university level, I was also the member earlier because of my exposure to IT. So I used to be there in almost every IT-related committee earlier. So, you know, I used to observe the things. I also had my own ideas about administration and so on. So it's not that I just jumped from academics to administration. It's a smooth process. Also, I studied here, and of course, I started working here. So I have a lot of, I would say, kind of associations towards this university.
So how do you de-stress yourself given the fact that you are always under pressure?
I was never under pressure. So, of course, we used to look at the problems. There are times when actually, you know, the problems increased, right, like anything. But then we had to sit and resolve those issues. That gave me a lot of satisfaction. So that's the reason probably I was never under pressure, right? So the satisfaction of working out a solution for a problem has never put me in pressure, I would say. Yeah, if it doesn't work, then we used to find out some alternative. We are in search of alternate solution, not you know, taking over the pressure, actually.
Sir, how do you manage your personal and professional life?
Yeah, I think that's an important question. See, I'm used to work long hours, even in the earlier times also. Before I became principal, of course, I was more into the research. We used to work even during the night times also. So, for almost 30 years, I would say my working hours are from 9 to 9. 9 a.m. to 9 p.m. Of course, there's a lot of support from my family also, particularly my wife, who is also a bank employee. So she understood me so well. And that is one of the reasons, you know, by which we can easily balance between the personal life and the professional life.
That was nice to hear. And sir, what's your message for OU students?
Yeah, I would say, you know, you are spending prime time of yours. It's very, very important. It'll never come back. Okay, and all the foundation has to be laid here only. Once you go out, actually, it is going to be a tough time. But it all depends how you shape yourself during this precious period. Don't let go waste that time. Spend the time, you know, fruitfully. It's very, very important. Because I was also a student, actually. So that time is so precious. In fact, when I came out, whatever the exam I wrote, I passed. Right? I could succeed in most of the examinations. Because that all depends, you know, how you have done during your, study period. So whatever you do, other things, but studies are very, very important. And coming days are going to be even tougher, I would say. The technology changing so fast. And still that, now skills that you possess now are no more useful after 1 year or 2 years. So again, you have to, gain new skills. Unless you have that competency, it is going to be become very difficult, actually. So you have to have that capability to adapt to the changes and acquire new skills quickly, right? And then be successful. So now you will be having looking at the problems which you have not seen earlier. I'm telling you, the new problems are going to emerge. So if you have to solve those problems, then obviously it should be very good. So foundation is very, very important.
Sir, do you have any unfinished task in your assessment?
Unfinished task, of course, I have started, a number of things we have initiated. Some of these things have not taken final shape. For example, we started doing automation. Now, we have launched a student information system. We have launched faculty information system. And now, recently, we also introduced that e-office. So all these measures are important to modernize this university. Now they are taking shape. So probably it requires another 6 months, before these things get stabilized. Hopefully this initiatives will be taken forward, and hopefully this will be finished. Okay. And I don't see there's a going back as far as these measures are concerned. As I told you, it could be automation or it could be on-screen evaluation. You must have heard of these things, right? Or okay, there are a number of digital transactions. Okay, there is what is known as NAD, National Academic Depository, and many other things which have been initiated during this period. So these things have to be completed. Okay, they have been started now, and people also started embracing this technology, and also they have realized the benefits of this technology. I don't think they will go back. The only thing is they have to be taken to their logical end, and these are all meant for changing the governance, I should say. This university has to become more responsive, more transparent, more accountable. So these things will come through this change, transformation. Okay, so digital transformation is taking place. So once again, I should thank all my stakeholders. They have accepted this technology. Okay. Yeah, only thing is, at the end, I would only say that this university has a very bright future. Right, the opportunity exists now. We have to grab this opportunity. Okay. And I'm sure, in future, you'll be better off in terms of the grants, and we will see a much more vibrant environment in the university. I wish for that, actually. Thank you.